Die in Hanau erschossen worden sind aufgrund einer rassistischen rechtsextremen Motivation. Es ist für uns unerträglich. Es ist die vierte Aktion in einem Jahr. Walter Lübcke, der Anschlag in Halle, aber auch die Unaufgeklärten, immer noch die Taten des NSU, das steht in einer Tradition. Und wir können es so nicht stehen lassen. Uns ist nicht zum Feiern zumute. Eine Gruppe von unterschiedlichsten Filmemachern, Schauspielern, Autorinnen und Autoren, die selber POC sind, People of Color, die selber mit Rassismuserfahrungen haben. Und wir hoffen, dass in der großen, breiten Solidarität auch von der Mehrheitsgesellschaft endlich wahrgenommen wird, dass wir uns positionieren müssen, jeden Tag. Mariam Sareh.
Das heißt, wenn Sie jetzt so ein bisschen zurückgezogen auf die Arbeit waren, heute ist auch einfach mal feiern angesagt, oder? Die Kollegen treffen. Wie begeht man so einen Tag?
Aber auch den Film als Ereignis
Jahre Berlinale, das heißt ja auch eine Stadtgeschichte, das heißt eine politische Geschichte. Was bedeutet das Festival?
Das Festival bedeutet im besten Sinne ein Spiegel von Zeitgeschichte, ein Spiegel von Geschichten über das Leben. Wir alle, glaube ich, sind interessiert, ins Kino zu gehen oder Filme zu sehen und Geschichten erzählen. Die Nähe zu anderen Menschen, anderen Schicksalen und vielleicht Verwandtschaft.
Eine ganz neue, riesige Anzahl von Filmen gezeigt und jedes Mal ist es eine große Entdeckung. Jedes Mal sitze ich mit der gleichen Neugier in einem Filmanfang. Ich finde ja die Filmanfänge meistens das Allerschönste. Manchmal komme ich im Theater zu spät, im Kino versuche ich auf gar keinen Fall je zu spät zu kommen, weil ich die Anfänge des Films so toll finde. Die ersten 20 Minuten, wenn man noch nicht weiß, wenn alles noch ein Versprechen ist, das ist das Schönste, das ist der schönste Moment im Kino.
Thank you. himself. It's the black guy himself.
We like to talk to Douglas, is it possible?
To who?
Douglas Bowie?
Douglas.
Are you representing the Salinger group?
I'm Helen Hadley and Brian O'Byrne.
Sorry?
I'm with Brian O'Byrne. That's Douglas Bowie. My colleagues sometimes might be with Douglas. What outlet are you back for?
We mostly want to speak to
Of course. Do you want Brian O'Byrne?
Who's...
He plays an assistant in the literary agency.
Which one? Which assistant?
I'm not sure.
You're not doing a good representation.
ZDF mal das Mikro kurz wegnehmen.
ZDF? Mikro!
Your feelings being here in Berlin.
I am so thrilled to be here. I I've never been to Berlin before, but I traveled all over Germany on tour for my Salinger year, and I loved it here. And I could not be happier that my film is opening at the Berlinale.
And what do you think about the cast, about especially the two women that play the main leads in the film?
Well, they are honestly my dream choices. Margaret Qualley was my first choice, and when she agreed to do it, I started crying. Sigourney Weaver is so perfect as Margaret. I can't imagine anyone else playing the role. She completely embodies it. So yeah, she's wonderful. I'm over the moon.
So congratulations and celebrate it tonight.
Thank you. Thank you. Hi. Yes, I feel like Philippe fully captured not just the story of my book, but the prose and the kind of emotional tenor of it. We worked very, very closely on the script. He used lots of my dialogue, lots of my ideas, and I feel so grateful and happy that he was so interested in having me be involved in it. That he didn't just want to make it his own thing. So, but he, of course, did make it his own thing. So.
Love it. I love it. I've actually only ever come here for work, so I need to make sure I come back and enjoy it as a tourist as well.
So, no offense, but in the film you're kind of in line B. How do you feel about...
In what?
In the line B. Like, how do you feel
What does
about
that mean, in the line B?
You have two strong women.
No, it's fantastic. No, it's fantastic. I mean, I think we need to make more movies with strong female leads. So, I wouldn't say that I was supporting. I wouldn't say I was supporting that. That Sigourney Weaver doesn't need my support. But it was a great pleasure for me to come in and to partake with those two. Both Margaret and Sigourney are people that I admire their work greatly. And Philip is a fantastic director that I've actually wanted to work with for a while. So, it was great to come in and support them. I was saying as I drove up, it's so impressive. It's such an iconic image. This film festival is one of the biggest in the world, and I got little tingles in my arm as I saw this iconic image here. So I feel very lucky to be here on the red carpet.
It's a great film. I mean, it's a New York film. What does it relate maybe to Berlin? It's also a cultural city.
A cultural city. That's a hard question. I don't know what's the relation. I think that Philip has shown here, the director. He's brought his movies to Berlin before, so it's an important. It's an important festival to him, so I think that may have been part of the decision and the programming. Thank you. Thank you so much.
Right there, lady in blue.
So we're telling a big story, but lots of surprises. It's not
really coming in. Yeah, we're trying to make it
over. She's a bit frosty, your character, isn't she?
We're going to go back.
She's a bit frosty, your character.
Sorry, we don't have the family shot. No,
she's not
the family
shot.
We're going to go back.
Sign all this, right?
are all done digitally. I'm actually here.
Are you celebrating tonight? It's a beautiful film.
Oh, yes, I'm so glad you liked it, yeah. No, I'm sorry.
I am always looking for your film.
Well, I've seen it, which is a big help. I'm just excited for Margaret to see it. She hasn't seen it.
Just down here at the start.
Sigourney! 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 Sigourney!
a little bit more about Berlin and why you're happy to be here. You can tell her now.
How does it feel to be on the red carpet right now?
I feel very happy. How do you feel?
Well, I feel very happy talking to you. It's amazing.
Good.
I love the film. And in the film, you have this, the student wardrobe. And now you have this amazing dress.
Thank you. I feel all dressed up is nice, and I'm happy to be here. Happy to be talking to you. Thanks.
How are you going to celebrate tonight?
I'm going to watch the movie, so I haven't seen it yet. I'm excited to see it.
It's
my first time.
Wow.
Yeah.
So, thank you so much.
Thank you.
Enjoy the evening.
It was nice to meet you. Why do I think,
Young ambitious people should see it.
I think the film, a big part of the film is about believing in yourself and realizing that it's okay to not have all the answers and still take a risk, you know, and that we're all kind of figuring it all out all the time. I know I am. So hopefully that gets across in the film.
How do you feel about dreams that you have and projects that you wish for yourself?
She came in.
In what way? I feel like I've been really, really lucky so far, and I really love my job, and I'm really lucky to be here, and I hope I get to keep doing it for a bit longer.
So after all this, how do you like Berlin?
I've barely been here, but so far it's been awesome. Hopefully I'll have a little bit of time tomorrow to explore, because I kind of just got in and came straight to this stuff.
The famous bird. Have you any chance to do
it? I haven't yet, but maybe I should. Maybe I'll have I don't know. Yeah. Okay. Nice to meet you guys.
You hope this film will resonate internationally with audiences.
Well, you know, the interesting thing about it, I actually saw it last week, I lived in New York as a young man at that same time period, and when I read the book, I was particularly taken by the scene of the drama that I painted, because I lived through it as a young man at the same time, so it resonated with me in that way. But the interesting thing about it, so many of my vintage and your vintage, is that it's actually, it's a time-based scene.
But the script, I read the script, obviously, and it's a reminiscing of a time that I actually miss, where people talked to each other and didn't text, and where people read books and just spent more time connecting with art. And so that movie spoke to me that way.
I guess most of the fans here recognize you as Michelle.
Yeah, yeah, I'm forever Michelle, but that's fine, I can live with that. It was a great character.
How do the fans react to you mostly? What is the most asked question you get?
The most asked question, well, people wonder if I have the accent, if I talk like this, you know, and so they're always surprised that I don't, but I'm French-Canadian, so that's the true connection with the character.
So will we ever see you again as Michelle?
I don't know. I don't think so. I don't know. It's not in my hands.
How do you prepare for events like this?
You dress up, you get a black tie, and you try to have a drink later on.
What was it like to work with Sigourney and Margaret and everyone?
They're both lovely, both incredibly talented, and very warm and friendly. So it was a nice relationship and friendship that came out of it.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Ich habe eine Frage.